Welcome back to the PV Pete Show. This is Pete Jones. Got a quick little vid for y'all out there. Some people were wondering, asking, how did I get my truck on the trailer and stay on the trailer? And I'm going to show you that here today. We're going to use this Ford Ranger Raptor. Pretty sweet mod. Listen to that sucker roar. Alright, we're going to take this. And you can do this in many different areas. I choose over here because I like to use the modded trailers that are lifted a little bit, so I need a little more height. Reverse. Go ahead and back this up. Put the parking brake on. Alright. Now we're going to come over here and let's use this deleted F-250. Yeah, let's go ahead and repair this. Or recover it so that it's fully repaired. We got any flatbeds sitting around here? Let's get a different one this time. There we go. Pretty sweet trailer if you ask me. Wider angle. Pretty cool. Alright. So there's my Ranger Raptor. Not too bad. It's not too bad. I think I can do a little better. I know parking brakes on. I'm just using it because it's easier to do a little. Well, I guess I'll just use first gear. I might just straighten this up a little bit. I think that'll roll alright. Next, what you're going to do is you're going to want to attach your winch. We'll go there and... that's pretty crooked. I think I can do better than that. I'm gonna have to drive forward, because what's gonna happen is, I didn't mean to do that. There we go. No harm, no foul. Alright, yeah, so we'll have to drive away, because if I don't, it'll just go through the trailer whenever I switch. Alright. So that's a good thing to show you here, actually. Did I damage it? Nope. Alright, cool. Let's try right here. This can be a little tricky sometimes. I want to make sure I shut it off so I can save fuel. I have not tried detaching the trailer to try to get it good straight winch point. Alright. Let's see what happens here. See, that's usually what happens. I've saved this before. That's not gonna let me. Oh, I'm still attached, okay. Yeah, it should be a neutral. Oh, come on. Try again. I'm messing this up. Like I said, this can be a bit tricky. Now we're damaged. Let's go over here and get this done. Alright, once again. Probably be a lot easier on me if I just did it on a regular trailer. But I really like to run those off-road trailers. Plus, they help not tip over too much so I don't drop the truck. Try this out. we go. I think this might be it. So. Alright. There you have it. Truck on trailer. I could have stopped it a little bit earlier, got it more centered on the trailer. But that's pretty good. Now, I did notice if I got too close to another truck, it dropped, but not this time. Must have been a bug. And let's take her down. Pretty sweet setup. Faster, see what happens. She just slides around. I normally drive pretty safe. Is it gonna slide? Not really. I think if I go too crazy, it'll fly off, but looks like if you accidentally get a little sideways, you should be okay. This is what I'm talking about with those trailers though. You see that? They just work better. Something I'd rather have when transporting a vehicle. Let's go off-road. So it's staying on pretty well. Oh, there we go. And that's what I was wondering, is how hard you gotta hit it to get it off. Like I said, I usually drive pretty safe, so. But it's still on. Getting some water damage here. Burying the truck. She's pulling through, though. Pretty awesome. And while she's on there, I'll go ahead and show you. When you get her off, you're just gonna fall through. Well, I hope you all had a good time. Hope this helps people wanting to load up inside their trailers and tow around. Or on top of the trailers and tow around. Pretty sweet truck there. But anyways, if you want to subscribe to the channel, that'd be awesome. Hit the notification bell. Let you know whenever I put a new video out. Thanks for watching.